Today we celebrate the feast of St. Dunstan, and we offer this Mass for the present soul of Metropolitan Hilarion Kapral, who was a first hierarch of the Russian Church outside of Russia, and who reposed, I think, on Monday. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost,
Amen.
I grant to the altar of God.
Even to the God who has joined by us.
Descend into the garden, defend my soul against ungodly people, and live me from deceitful and wicked man.
Thou art our God, thou art our strength. Why hast thou flown from thee? And why voice so heavily while the enemy oppresses
me? O send thou thy light and thy truth, that may lead me and bring them by early hill into thy dwelling.
And that I may love the altar to God, even God who has joined by us. And upon my heart will I give thanks unto thee, O God, my God.
Why thou say heavy my soul, why thou say smart within me?
O put thy trust in God, for I will give him thanks, which is the help of my countenance and my God.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
And we go unto the altar of God,
even to the God of my joy blessed.
And I help in the name of the Lord,
who hath made me heaven and earth.
I confess to Almighty Blessed Mary, the Virgin, Blessed Michael, the Archangel, Blessed John the Baptist, the Holy Apostles, Peter and Paul, and all the saints, and you brothers and sisters, my sin, mixing in thought, word, and deed. By my fault, by my own fault, by my misdeeds fault. But I beg, Blessed Mary, the Virgin, Blessed Michael, the Archangel, Blessed John the Baptist, the Holy Apostles, Peter and Paul, all the saints, and you brothers and sisters, to pray to me to the Lord our God.
God Almighty, have mercy upon thee, forgive thee thy sins, and bring thee to everlasting life.
Amen.
I confess to God Almighty, to Blessed Mary, the Virgin, to Blessed Michael, the Archangel, to Blessed John the Baptist, to the Holy Apostles Peter and Paul, to all the saints and to thee, Father, that I have sinned exceedingly in thought, word, and deed, by my fault, by my own fault, by my own grievous fault. Wherefore I beg, Blessed Mary, the Virgin, Blessed Michael, the Archangel, Blessed John the Baptist, the Holy Apostles Peter and Paul, to all the saints and to thee, Father, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
God Almighty, have mercy upon you, forgive your sins, and bring you to everlasting life.
Amen.
Almighty, merciful the Lord, grant us power and absolution and remission of all our sins.
Amen.
And may not turn again, and quicken us, O God.
That thy people may rejoice in thee.
The Lord, show thy mercy upon us.
And grant us thy salvation.
The Lord, hear my prayer.
And let my cry come unto thee.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord hath established a covenant of peace with him, and made him a chief of his people, that he should have the priestly dignity forever. Alleluia, alleluia. Lord, remember David and all his trouble. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be,
world without end. Amen.
The Lord hath established a covenant of peace with him, and made him a chief of his people, that he should have the priestly dignity forever and ever. Alleluia, alleluia. Hear, O Lord Jesus Christ, therefore shalt thou love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us. Glory be to God on high.
And on earth, peace to his will towards men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, heavenly God, Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God,
Lamb of God,
Son of God, that takes away the sins of the world,
have mercy upon us.
God, that takes away the sins of the world,
receive our prayer.
Thou dost sit at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art
vine of the Lord, thou only oak Jesus Christ, high and glory of the God the Father. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. O God, who hast elevated blessed Dunstan, thy bishop, in thy heavenly kingdom, grant that we likewise, aided by his glorious intercession, may pass into joy everlasting. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who hast made thy servant Hilarion to flourish among the ministers of apostolic succession in the honorable office of a bishop, grant, we beseech thee, that he may also be joined with thine apostles in the perpetual fellowship. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end.
Amen.
Please be seated for the reading.
The epistle is written in the 44th chapter of Ecclesiasticus, beginning at the 16th verse. Behold, a great priest who in his days pleased the Lord and was found righteous, and in the time of wrath he was taken in exchange for the world. There was none like unto him to keep the law of the Most High. Therefore, by an oath, the Lord assured him that he would increase him among his people. He established with him the blessing of all men and the covenant, made it rest upon his head. He acknowledged him in his blessing, and preserved for him his mercy, so that he found favor in the sight of the Lord. He magnified him in the sight of kings, and gave unto him a crown of glory. An everlasting covenant he made with him, and gave him a great priesthood, and blessed him with glory, that he should execute the office of the priesthood and have honor in his name and offer unto him incense and a sweet savor. Here endeth the epistle.
Thanks
be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, thou art a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek, alleluia. This is the priest whom the Lord hath crowned.
Spirit.
The continuation of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
At that time, when Jesus spake this parable unto his disciples, a man traveling into a far country called his own servants, and delivered unto them his goods. And unto one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, and to another 1, to every one according to his several ability, and straightway took his journey. Then he that had received the 5 talents went and traded with the same, and made them other 5 talents. And likewise he that received 2, he also gained other 2. But he that had received 1 went and digged in the earth, and hid his Lord's money. After a long time the Lord of those servants cometh and reckoneth with them, and so he that hath received the 5 talents came and brought other 5 talents, saying, Lord, thou deliverest unto me 5 talents. Behold, I have gained beside them a 5 talents more. His Lord said unto him, Well done, thou good and faithful servant. Thou hast been faithful over a few things. I will make thee ruler over many things. Enter thou into the joy of thy Lord. He also that had received 2 talents came and said, Lord, thou deliverest unto me 2 talents. Behold, I have gained 2 other talents beside them. His Lord said unto him, Well done, good and faithful servant. Thou hast been faithful over a few things, I will make thee ruler over many things. Enter thou into the joy of thy Lord.
Praise be to thee, O Christ.
Please be seated. So, as I said, celebrate the memory of St. Dunstan, one of England's greatest saints, a Benedictine monk who was successively abbot of Glastonbury, Bishop of Worcester, Bishop of London, and finally Archbishop of Canterbury, where he died May 19, 1988. He died just after receiving communion, the words of the psalmist on his lips, "The Lord feeds those who fear him." And what wonderful words these are for us to think about, we, as we ourselves prepare to receive communion. This communion in which the Lord feeds us with his body, feeds us with his blood. What a wonderful thing. Not a bare sign, not a naked symbol, not a bit of bread, not a sip of wine, but the body of the Lord, his blood, his soul, his Godhead, him given wholly and totally to us to be our food and our drink. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. I have found David my servant, and my holy oil I have anointed him. My hand shall hold him fast, my arm shall strengthen him. Alleluia. Pray, brothers and sisters, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
And the Lord receive the sacrifice of thy hands, to the praise and glory of his name, both for our benefit and for all of his holy church.
Amen. beseech you also, so that direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly be impartial and justice, to the punishment of wickedness and vice, and the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, especially Joseph, our metropolitan, and John, our bishop, that they may both by their life and doctrine set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy good sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, especially this congregation here present, that with meek heart and reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And most humbly we seek thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succour all those who, in this transient life, are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we pray especially for peace, we pray for those suffering in the war in Ukraine, especially for Metropolitan Luthery and his flock. We pray for Metropolitan Paul and Archbishop John, who have captured by ISIS. We pray for Father Lairs and Courier Sue, Kay, Paul, Caleb, Ed, and Mia, Galena, Chris, Anthony, James, Matthew, Phoebe, Katie, Drew, Olivia, Melissa, Becky, Alice, Father Jason, Elizabeth, Jack Shea, Kathleen, Richard, Carol, Maria, Aaron, Laura, Abby, and Jeremy, Aaron, Carol, Jim, Sharon, Chad, Jack Leahy, Ginger, Judy, Darlene, Chase, and Amanda, Dakota, and Josephine, Cindy, Mark, Shrita, and Scott Vanderwall, Steve, Mia, Joni, Max, Phoebe and family, Gerald, Connor, Nelson, and Kathy. We pray to you for all those who have asked our prayers, all those who we know to be in need of prayer, all whom we know and all whom we know. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants, depart this life and thy faith and fear, beseeching you to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow the good examples of Blessed Mary and all thy saints, that through their intercession we with them may partake of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant us, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen. Amen.
Hear our comfort words, our Saviour Christ said to all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, O ye that travail under heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. He also, as St. Paul said, this is a true saying, and worthy of all to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. He also, as St. John said, that if anyone sinned, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right so to do.
It is very meet to right in our bounden duty and mission at all times and in all places. Give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, everlasting, almighty everlasting God. But chiefly are we bound to praise thee for the glorious resurrection of thy Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. For he is the very paschal lamb which was offered for us, and hath taken away the sin of the world, who by his death hath destroyed death, and by his rising to life again hath restored to us everlasting life. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we lord and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy,
Holy, Holy, Holy, Lord of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord most high.
Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord,
who is our
all glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for thou art thy tender mercy to thy only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, through his by his own oblation of himself once offered, made a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world. And in institute and in his holy gospel commands to continue, a perpetual memory of that his precious death and sacrifice until his coming again. For in the night he received his cake of bread, and when he knew thanks, he brake it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the new New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as you shall drink it, in remembrance of me. Wherefore, O Lord, and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy beloved Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, we thy humble servants celebrate thee here before thy divine majesty. With these thy holy gifts we offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make. Having remembered his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks to you, all benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us. And of thy almighty goodness our Saviour, send down thy Holy Spirit upon these thy gifts and preach the bread and wine, that they may be changed into the body and blood of thy most dear beloved Son. Grant we receiving them according to thy Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, so institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may we be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we rightly desire thy fatherly goodness, mercy, accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Most humbly beseech you to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain the remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee. Humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may well receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, may one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. Remember, Lord, also the souls of thy servants and handmaidens, which have gone before us for the mark of faith and a rest in the sleep of peace. And we pray especially for Metropolitan Valerian, for whom we offer the sacrifice. We pray for Archbishop Victor, Aconis Shukrala, Don Denis, Father Gregory, Father Paul, Father Anthony, Father Isaac, Father Bernard, Father Justin, Curia Patricia, Deacon John, Curia Hafita, Curia Cartoon, Subdeacon Lawrence, Hayward, John, Mary, Seth, Valerie, Laurie, and Frederick. We pray too for all those who died recently or those whose anniversaries occur at this time. We remember all our relatives, our friends, and benefactors, and together with them we remember those who are most forgotten and most neglected. We beseech thee, O Lord, that under them and under all such as rest in Christ, thou wilt grant a place of refreshment and light and of peace. And vouchsafe to give unto us some portion and fellowship with thy holy apostles and martyrs, with John, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucia, Mysticia, Anastasia, and with all thy saints, within whose fellowship we beseech thee to admit us. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer up unto thee sacrifice, yet we beseech to accept this our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offences, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. By whom and with whom in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray. And now, as our Saviour Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Throughout all ages, world without end.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
O Lamb of God, who takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, who takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy.
We do not presume
to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as gather at the arms under that table. But thou hast the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Bring on us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that thou sympathize to be completely by his body, and thou so wash through his most precious blood, and that we may no more fail of him in the given us. Amen.
Behold, the Lamb of God.
Behold, the
Lord. Lord, I am aware that thou shalt come on my roof.
But the sweet word only my soul shall be healed.
Lord, I am aware that thou shalt come on my roof.
But the sweet word only my soul shall be healed.
Lord, I am aware that thou shalt come on my roof.
But the sweet word only my soul shall be healed.
I believe, O Lord, I confess,
that thou art truly the Christ, the Son of the living God, who is coming to the world to save sinners.
to show us that I am that faith and goodness towards us, and that we are members and co-operative and mystical body of thy Son, which is the best company of all faithful people. And are also heirs for hope of thy everlasting kingdom, when the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech you, Heavenly Father, save us, sisters, with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship, and do all such works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, and of one God, and world without end.
Amen.
A faithful and wise servant whom the Lord hath made ruler of his household, to give them their portion of meat in due season, and of good.
The Lord be with you,
and with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Grant we beseech you, Almighty God, we show forth our thankfulness, may the intercession of Blessed Dunstan, my Bishop Confessor, obtain your more abundant mercies. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who giveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray. We beseech you, Lord, thy merciful loving kindness, which we implore, may benefit the soul of thy servant of Aaron, thy Bishop, that by thy mercy he may attain unto the eternal fellowship of him in whom he hoped and believed. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end.
Amen.
The Lord be with you,
and with thy spirit.
Depart in peace.
Thanks be to God.
And the peace of God which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen. And with thy spirit.
The beginning of the very gospel according to God.
Glory to thee, O Lord.
In the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God, the same as in the beginning of God. All things were made by him, not in him was not anything made was made. In him was life, and the light is the light of men, and the light shineth in the darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John, to save him for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all through him might believe. He was not that light, but sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light which lighted upon the countenance of the world. He was in the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own received him not. But as many as received him, then gave power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of the world. And the Word was made flesh, and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory of him beyond the world.